wait. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, groove. Baby girl, watch how you move.
What?
I got them vests on my shoes.
I pop a pill and I lose.
Wait, speed it up. Look at the diamonds, they eat it up. Damn it, two bitches, I've eat it up.
They thinking I'm wife and deleting them. Oh, wait.
Pints in, call up Rocky. My brother pull like a sock.
Alrighty, guys, it is time for the hot oil treatment process. So I'm just going to be pairing up with my olive oil and my coconut oil, and I'm making enough of this mixture so that I can later use this mixture in my deep conditioning routine. So I'm pretty much putting this in an applicator bottle. Then I'm going to just take my mug, put it in the microwave for about 2 to 3 minutes, make sure that the water is piping hot, and place my applicator bottle inside of the mug for about 8 to 10 minutes, just letting those oils warm up. As you all know, coconut oil is a solid, so you want to just make sure that once that is done being a solid and it turns into a liquid form, that it's good to go. Also, be sure to test your hot oil treatment on the back of your hand to make sure that it is suitable for your scalp. So let's talk a little bit about what a hot oil treatment is, or a pre-poo. And pretty much this is just a step before you shampoo or clarify your scalp to really get that excess flakes, dirt, all of that dandruff off of your scalp. So I'm using olive oil because it's rich in vitamins A, E, and antioxidants. Also, olive oil helps protect the keratin in your hair and seal in the moisture. And olive oil is also really good for hot oil treatments because it can remove the buildup of the sebum that impedes the formation of new hair follicles and hinders growth. So what that means in a nutshell is that it has it's penetrative enough to get all of that buildup off your scalp to pretty much make a clear and easy pathway for new hair to grow. So coconut oil, as we know, has antibacterial agents and properties that allow scalps to not get inflammatory and things like that. So that's why it's also great for hot oil treatments. And hot oil treatments allow for you to get that blood flow circulating, especially when you massage your scalp when doing a hot oil treatment. It really allows for your hair to grow, and like I said, just really get that excess buildup off of your scalp that sometimes shampoos do not do. I'm also sure to focus my hot oil treatment on my ends of my hair because that is the oldest part of my hair. And you want to make sure that you're just giving your hair that extra nutrients. And it's okay that you're doing a scalp, you know, you do the hot oil treatment before you shampoo, because you want to make sure that your hair is not super greasy and weighed down by all of these oils. You can also begin to do your detangling process when doing the hot oil treatment, but you don't necessarily have to. So I do all of that, make sure that my whole scalp is lathered. Make sure that you wear a shirt that you don't care about getting messed up with. And I put that shower cap on my head for about 30 minutes, and then now it's time to clarify my scalp. So when I get in the shower, I just turn on some warm water to open up my cuticle and just rinse my scalp. You want to make sure that when you shampoo that you're focusing the shampoo on your scalp, because as you rinse the shampoo down the rest of the shaft of your hair, the rest of the hair is being clarified. You don't have to lather your whole hair in shampoo. I'm also pairing up this shampoo with the Vanity Planet Massage Scalp Brush. This brush, like I've said, and I've raved about this on my channel for about a year now, it really has aided my hair growth. It is making sure that I'm getting that blood flow and that circulation on the scalp, really making a clear pathway for my hair to grow through. So it's just really getting that blood flow working and circulating so that my hair can continue to grow without having a stunted growth, because I'm not getting any circulation on my scalp. So I shampoo my hair about twice with my Vanity's Planet brush, and now I've moved on to the detangling process. So I go in with my Mielle Organics Co-Wash Detangling Conditioner, and I'm just going to begin to lather my hair with the product. I personally get the best results when I detangle underwater. Some people's hair is not the same, but for me, the combination of the conditioner as well as the water gliding through the comb allows for me to have less shedding and really allows for that product to work the best, especially if it's a good conditioner, to really get my hair detangled and not like knotted up. I personally like to do all of this process in the shower too, just because I like for my hair to be soaking wet, especially when I am detangling. So as you can see, I've thoroughly I'm still detangling, but it's not, detangling is never really a super nightmare for me, especially if I'm doing it when my hair is super super wet. So now it's time to deep condition. I deep condition every time I wash my hair. This is the Shea Moisture Manuka Honey, whatever, olive oil. It's a good deep conditioner. That's all I can say. And I go in with my hot oil treatment mix and I mix it in there too, because like I said, olive oil and coconut oil are such penetrative oils. And I'm not necessarily letting this mask stay in my hair. It's just only to sit on top of my hair. So in this mask, there is Manuka Honey Oil, which contains anti-inflammatory properties that soothe the scalp and creates a moisturizing barrier. There's also Mafura oil, which contains high levels of beneficial oleic acid that helps replenish stripped oils from the hair. This deep conditioner also contains African rock fig that has antioxidants like vitamin C that keeps the hair vibrant in appearance. So overall, I really love this deep conditioner, especially for the wintertime, because it is so thick, creamy, and it's penetrative, and I know that it works. You want to make sure that you focus your deep conditioner on the ends of your hair, because that is the oldest part of your hair, and you want to make sure that we keep all strands of our hair super moisturized and making sure that they're getting all of the ingredients, the recipes, everything that they need so that they can stay strong and that, you know, your hair does not begin to break off. That's one of the biggest problems a lot of people have with retaining length and keeping moisture in their hair, is because they don't focus on the ends of their hair. You want to make sure that your hair is moisturized. I don't stress anything more than I douche moisture. So now I'm following up my deep conditioner with my Q-Redo. So this part is not necessarily, it's not needed if you don't have to. If you don't have this Q-Redo, that's fine. You can continue to stay in the shower and allow that steam from the shower to get on your hair. But I just haven't used my steamer in a while, and I really love how my hair feels after I steam my hair. So the hair steaming while deep conditioning, it encourages blood flow to circulate. So that promotes hair growth, and the steam really lifts the hair cuticle, allowing the treatment to deeply penetrate into the hair shaft, helping damaged hair. So my hair is not necessarily damaged, but this is pretty much a precautionary measure. I'm not gonna end up having damage because I put so much moisture into my hair, not on an overload measure, but I make sure that my hair has a healthy balance of moisture, allowing it to not get damaged. So you, like I said, you don't have to necessarily steam with a steamer. You can steam in the shower, or you can sit under a hooded dryer to deep condition, or you can just deep condition. But for me, I like to make sure that since it's the colder and it's the winter months, I want my hair to have as much moisture so that it can be strong and it can be protected from the harsh cold winds of outside. So I just rinse my scalp or my hair with a cold water to shock the cuticle so I can keep all of that moisture that I had inside. But this is my hair, super soft, super manageable, and I can go into any style with this. But for this particular day, I did go into a winter wash and go. So go and check that video out, because that is something that's super moisturizing and ideal for the colder months. So I hope this video was helpful. My hair routine doesn't really change that much, but like I said, I hope it was helpful. Be sure to check out my winter wash and go, and I'll see you all in my next one. Bye.